मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस चैप्टर 3 प्लेइंग विथ नंबर एक्सरसाइज 3.5। क्वेश्चन नंबर 2, इन दिस एक्सरसाइज इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 वी हैव हियर टू डिफरेंट द फैक्टर्स 3 फॉर 60 द गिवन एंड राइट द मिसिंग नंबर। सो लुक, यू कैन सी हियर, यह दिस इज गिवन फर्स्ट फैक्टर 3 ऑफ 60, इसलिए गिवन हियर दिस इज 60। ओके, नाउ इट हैव टू ब्रांचेस, दिस बिकम्स दिस इज 6 एंड दिस इज इक्वल टू व्हाट 10। ओके, आफ्टर दिस 6 ब्रेक टू ब्रांचेस लाइक दिस, फर्स्ट ब्रांच इज हियर दिस इज गिवन 2 and this is here nothing. Okay, so we need to put here missing numbers. What is the number here? And the next branch, this is 10, this is also given like this. This is one branch and here this is 5 and here this is nothing. So you also find the missing number and write here. Okay, so what is the possible missing numbers here? So you can see here this is 6 and this is 2. First you can see here this is 6 and 10. It means 60 and 10, 6 is 60. If you multiply this into this, then you have to this. So here this is 6 and here 2, here nothing. So if you multiply this and this, then you have to this numbers. Okay. For this find number of years, we do the product of them, this number and this number, 2 and this number is 6. So if you divide 6 by 2, then you obtain this numbers. Okay, so if you divide 6 by 2, so you obtain 6 by 2, this is equal to 3. So here you obtain 3, this is the missing numbers. Okay, and so I hope all of you understood how to find missing number, because here you can see this is 60 and this is a product of 6, 10 into 6, 10 into 10 into 6, this is a product of 6, this is equal to 60, but here this is 6. So this means, it means that this is the product of this and this. Okay, but this is missing number. So if you divide this number 6 by 2, then you obtain this number. So here you obtain 3 and this is 2 into 3, this is equal to 6. Okay, so same formula we apply here. You can see here 10 into 6, this is equal to 60. It means that this into this 5 is equal to 10. If 5 divides 10, they obtain this formula, this missing numbers. So if you divide 10 by 5, you can write, then you obtain 2. So here you can write 2. Clear? So 5 to 10. So student, I hope all of you understood this factor tree of 60. Okay, first we break 60 in 2 part, 10 into 5. 6, this is 10 into 6, then you obtain 60. Suppose here this is a missing number. Okay, so how to find this number? Then you divide 60 by 10, then you can obtain here 6. Okay, so because this is a product of 10 into 6 is equal to 60. Now the second part of this question is 60 again given, and wait, first we read it. So I hope all of you understood. You have no question related to this factor tree, no? Okay, so let's see, first we raise it, after this we solve second part of this question number 2. This is given here, and this is 60. Okay, we break into two parts. First part is 30. And the second part is what? Nothing. Okay, this is missing numbers. Clear? Now, again second part break into two parts. Here and there. Clear? So this part is given 10. This is 10. This is missing numbers. Okay? And next part is, this part is also becomes two part. Okay? And this is 5. And this is missing number. Okay, so you can see this is 60, 30, 10, 5. Okay, missing number, missing number, missing number, missing number. Okay. So you can see a 60 break two part. One part is 30 and other part is not given. So I will find the this part. Okay. If you divide 30, if you divide 60 by 30, then you obtain 2. So here this is the missing number is 2. So here if you multiply 2 into 60, 2 into 30, then you obtain 60. Clear? Now, again, here you can see this is 30. Again, 30 divided 2 part. This is 10. What is this? This is missing number, nothing. So if you divide 30 by 10, then you obtain this number. If you divide 30 by 10, so obviously you know very well this is equal to 3. Okay? Clear? Now, and this number is 10, and 10 also break two part. One part is 5, the other part is, this is missing number. So if you divide this 10 by 5, then you obtain 2. So here missing number is 2. So student, I hope all of you understood this question. Branch of factorial of 60 in two different way. In the first way, the 60 break 30 into 2 in first way, and the second way, this 60 break 60 into 10. So in this way, we find the missing number in different condition. If you multiply two branches, two number, then you obtain 60, such as 30 into 2, this is equal to 60, and 6 into 10 also is equal to 60. Okay, so you can use the product method and find the missing numbers. Now, in this way, you complete this question exercise number 3.5. And now we are going to discuss question number 3. This is question number 2. Okay, this is related to factor 3. Factor 3. And now we are going to discuss question number 3. Question number 3 have which factors are not including in the terms in the prime factorization of a composite number. This is the question again. Which factors are not including in the prime factors in the prime factorization of composite numbers? So in this factors 1 and itself number are not including. Okay, in prime factorization of composite numbers 1 and itself number is not including. Okay, now, so this is the answer of question number 3. What is the question number 3? Question number 3 have which factors are not included in the prime factorization of a composite number. Okay, so which factors? 1 and itself numbers is not included in the prime factorization of the composite number. Now, so student, I hope all of you understood these questions, in that which factor is not included in the prime factorization of composite number. So 1 and itself the numbers. Okay, if you listen 1 and itself the number, then you something create on your mind the definition of this prime numbers. Prime number have two factors, 1 and itself the number. Okay, and now we are going to discuss question number 4. What is question number 4? Question number 4 have write a greatest 4 digit number. Write a greatest 4 digit number and express it in the term of prime factors. Express it in the term of prime factors. So student, first tell me what is the greatest 4 digit number. What is the greatest 4 digit number? So obviously you can say that it is the 9999. Very good. So let's see how to find its prime, how to we express it in prime factors. Okay, so for this, first we erase it. After this, we write the greatest 4 digit number. Question number 4. And we test 4 digit number. is equal to what? 9999. This is the greatest 4-digit number. So we need to express in prime factors. Okay? So first we find prime factors of 9999 by prime factorization methods. Okay? So here you can write 9999. Okay? So we can write here. We need to find prime factorization of this number. So first we select its max number, this is 3, divides this number, this will 3, 3, 3, 3. Again, this is 3, 1, 1, 1, 1. And now, which number is divisible? So you can say, this is 0 by 11, so 201. Okay, so you can see here, this is 101, and here, this is a prime number, 101 is prime number, so we can take 101 times. Okay, now, so you can express the greatest 4-digit number 9999 is 3 into 3 into 11 into 101. Okay, this is question number. This is solution of question number 4. Question number 4 have the write the is greatest 4-digit numbers. So here first write the greatest 4-digit number. You can see 9999. After this, the question asks to us express it in the terms of its prime factors. So first we find the prime factor of 9999. After this we express here. Okay, you can see. You can express 9999 is equal to 3 into 3 into 11 into 101. This is clear? Now, next question. What is the next question? Question number 5. This is given. Write the smallest 5-digit numbers and express it in the form of prime factorization. Prime factors, okay? So question, I repeat the question. Listen, write the smallest 5-digit number and that express it in the form of the prime factors, okay? So first you write smallest 5-digit number. So what is smallest 5-digit number? So let's say smallest 5-digit number is, tell me. Okay. 10,000. Okay, so let's see. Now the smallest 5-digit number is equal to smallest 5-digit number is equal to and number is 10,000. Okay, so here this is a 5-digit smallest 5-digit number is 10,000. Clear? We need to expect in prime factors. Okay, so for prime factorization, first you find the factors of this. So how can you find? We use factorization methods. So for this, we can write here 10,000. This is smallest 5-digit numbers. First you divide it 2, then you obtain 5,000. Again divide it 2 and 25. And again 2, 1, 2, 5, 0, again 2, 6, 2, 5, this is 5, 1, 2, 5, again by 5, 25, again by 5, this is equal to 5, again by 5 is equal to 1. So here you can say 4 times 4, 2 and the 4 times 5. So you can express it 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 5 into 5 into 5 into 5. Okay, this is a pair group of 2, group of 5. So you can see here, in this way you express the smallest 5 digit numbers in the prime factor. This is called 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 5 into 5 into 5 into 5. 2 to 4 times 2 into 5, 4 times 5. This is a factor sub. And this smallest 5 digit numbers. Okay, so now we are going to discuss next questions. I hope all have understood this question. Next question is find the all prime factors of 1729. So first we need to express, write the all factors 1729, okay, and arrange them in ascending orders. Okay, arrange it in ascending orders. After this, now state the relation, if any, between two consecutive prime factors. Okay, so let's see how to do this question. So here, this is question number 6. We express the given number 1729. This is 29, not 25. Okay, in its prime factors and ascending or descending order. So if you find, so first you divide this number by 7. Okay, so this 37, this is product of 13 and we have 19. Okay, so this is a factors of 1729, and you can see this is also in ascending orders. And the question arises, yes, what is the relation between the two consecutive prime factors? Okay, so you can see the relation between, first you can see this is the ascending orders, because 7 is less than 13 and 13 is less than 19. Okay, and question asks, what is the relation between two consecutive prime numbers? So here you can see the difference of any two consecutive prime number is 6. 13 minus 7, this is equal to 6. 19 minus 13, this is equal to 6. The difference of any consecutive prime numbers of this factor is 6. So you cannot hear the difference of two consecutive prime factor is 6. Okay, so the difference, the difference of two consecutive prime factors, prime factors is 6. Okay. So student, I hope all have understood how to find the prime factor of 1729 and how to write it ascending order, and what is the relation between any two prime factors, consecutive prime factors. So here you can see that they are differ by 6. First this is 13 and 7, this is differ by 6. 19 and 13, this is also differ by 6. This is the relation between prime factors. Okay, the difference of any two consecutive prime factors of 1729 is 6. Okay, so now we are going to discuss next question. Next question is question number 8. And next question number 7. This is given, and the product of three consecutive numbers is divisible by 6. The product of three consecutive numbers individual by 6. Verify this statement with the help of some examples. Okay, so first we let consecutive 3 consecutive numbers and after this multiply it, and if we check this individual by 6 and 9 or not. Okay, so suppose first we let smallest 3 consecutive numbers, this is a 1 2 3, this is the consecutive numbers. So first find their product. Okay, so 1 into 2 into 6, 3, this is equal to 6. Here this is divisible by 6. Okay, again we take, you can see the product of 3 consecutive numbers, 1 2 3, this is consecutive numbers. If you find product, so 1 into 2 into 3, 1 into 2 2 2 into 3, this is equal to 6. Now next consecutive groups which take 4 5 6, 4 comma 5 comma 6, so 4 into 5 into 6, this is equal to what? 4 5 are 20 20 and 6 120 120, also divisible by 6. Okay, 120 is also divisible by 6, and this is after 20. Here you can see the product of any 3 consecutive numbers is divisible by 6. Again we take another groups of 3 consecutive numbers like this. This is 10 11 12. So product of this is consecutive numbers, 10 11 12, so product of this is 10 into 11 into 12. So this is equal to 12 1 that 12 carry 2, 12 1 again 12, plus 1 13, this. So product of this number is this. Okay, so this is a check, this is divisible by 6 or not. So this is 1320 divided by 6, then we obtain here 220. Clear? So also you can see here this number is also divisible by 3. We take first examples 1 2 3, this is a consecutive 3 consecutive numbers, and say the product of this number is divisible by 6. Also we take the 3 consecutive numbers 4 5 6, and their product is 4 into 5 into 6 is 120, and 120 is also divisible by 6. And again we take 10 11 and 12, so you find the product of 10 into 11 into 12 is 1320. Here you can see 1320 divisible by 6. Okay, so in this way you can say the product of 3 consecutive number is always divisible by 6. Clear? So I hope all of you understood these questions. Okay, again we repeat the question number 7. The product of 3 consecutive numbers is always divisible by 6. Verify this statement with the help of some examples. So first we take the consecutive numbers 1, 2, 3 and find the product. This is equal to 6. So 6 is divisible by 6. You can say the product of 3 consecutive numbers is divisible by 6. Now again we take next consecutive numbers 4, 5, 6 and try to find the multiple. 4 into 5 into 6 is 120, and 120 is also divisible by 6. So in this way you can see the product of 3 consecutive numbers is divisible by 6. Again next we take 3 consecutive numbers 10, 11 and 12, and we find the product of 10 into 11 into 12 is 1320. But here you can see this is divisible by 6. So in this way we can say the product of any 3 consecutive numbers is divisible by 6. Now we are going to discuss the next question, question number 8. The sum of 2 consecutive odd numbers is divisible by 4. The sum of 2 consecutive odd numbers is divisible by 4. Verify this statement with the help of some examples. Okay, so here given the sum of 2 consecutive odd numbers, is divisible by 4. So let's see how to verify this. Okay, so this is question number 8. In this question, sum up to 8 consecutive odd numbers is divisible by 4. Okay, so first, what is odd numbers? You know very well, a number which is not divisible by 2, this is called odd numbers. Okay, consecutive odd numbers means like this 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15, 17, 19, 21, 23, 25, 27, and so on. This is a consecutive odd numbers, but here we take only two odd numbers, consecutive odd numbers, and find their sum and check this is divisible by 4 or not. So let's see how to do it. So here first we take 3 and 5. This is two consecutive odd numbers. Okay, their sum is equal to 3 plus 5, this is equal to 8. And you can see 8 is the multiple of 4. As you can see, 8 is divisible by 4. 4 divides 8. It means that this is right. Sum of 2 consecutive odd numbers divisible by 4. Let's see. And the examples again we take 2 consecutive odd numbers 13 and 15. 13, 15. This is 2 consecutive odd numbers. And now we need to find their sum. What is their sum? So 13 plus 15. This is equal to what? Nothing but 28. Both are 13 and 15. Both are odd numbers. And they are, you can say they are consecutive odd numbers. And their sum is 28. But what is this? 28 is a multiple of 4. It means that 4 divides 28. So 4 divided 28, how many times? You can see 7 times. So what is the conclusion here? Yes, this is according to two examples, and we take two consecutive odd numbers and find their sum, and we observe that the result is divisible by 4. Okay, and now we take another example and try to find, and this is not divisible by 4. So we take 17 and 19, two consecutive odd numbers. 17 and 19 is two consecutive odd numbers, and their sum will be 17 plus 19. Okay, this is equal to 36. This is equal to 36. So 36 is divisible by 4 or not? You can, of course, 36 is the multiple of 4, because 9 4 is 36, it means that 36 divide, 4 divided 36. 4 divided 36. So, in this questions, we can say the sum of any two consecutive odd numbers is divisible by 4. So, here we take three examples in front of you. First example is, this is 3 and 5. Both are consecutive odd numbers, and their sum is 8. 8 is the multiple of 4. Or you can say 8 is divisible by 4. And again we take the next examples, 13 and 15. And they are consecutive odd numbers, and their sum is 28. Also 28 is the multiple of 4. You can say the 28, 4 divided 28 in how many times? 7 times. And after this we take next example, 17 and 19. So this is the consecutive odd numbers, and their sum is 36. Here what you can see here 36 is multiple of 4. It means that 4 divided 36. So then you can say any two consecutive odd numbers, then any two sum of consecutive odd numbers is divisible by 4. So hence this is a verified. Okay. So student, I hope all of you understood such type questions, and enough for today. Thank you for watching. Jai Hind.